Hello, and welcome. I'm Hadija Chamberlain. When we last left off, archvillain Rafam and his villainous quartet of evil malcontents made off with the magical city of Dalaran. Now, the Year of the Dragon continues. The League of Evil has traveled south to unleash the second phase of their plans. But heroes have heard the land's cries for help, and there may yet be a chance for its salvation.
Darker than they've ever been.
I'm a hero.
As evil descends from the skies, the world cries out, how will we survive? Out of the hall of explorers, and up from the dusty tomb, they grab their whips and fedoras. These legends of the past know exactly what to do.
Rafam and his league may be intent on bending Uldum's ancient magics to their evil schemes, but there is hope. The League of Explorers is back. Reno, Elise, Bran, and the esteemed Sir Finley Murgleton are returning to Hearthstone, but this time, they're not just here for adventure or treasures. They're here to save the world. Of course, no call to adventure, no matter how noble, would be complete without a worthy quest. Any questing druid, for example, who ends four turns with unspent mana will obtain a powerful reward, a passive hero power that gives you both effects of your choose one cards. The masterminds of evil are also canvassing Uldum for artifacts. Rafam brings his very particular set of skills to his fellow warlocks in the form of supreme archaeology. All warlocks must do to complete this quest is what they do best. Draw cards. A lot of cards. Their reward? The Tome of Origination, giving them a hero power that draws a card and reduces its cost. Hopefully you still have a few left. With all this questing going on, you may want a little help. Fortunately, these ruins are crawling with curious adventurers willing to lend their aid. The stakes for our heroes have never been higher. Rafam is bringing about the end of days, unleashing a series of devastating plagues. Like a plague of death. Most plagues just wimp out and settle for disease or pestilence or whatever, but this one is just straight up death. Silenced death. The deathiest death. Now, plagues aren't known for being picky about their targets, and all of the plague cards in the set have a catastrophic effect that impacts both players, so it's good to be the one in control of it. Now, Uldum is a land of ancient magics and many strange denizens, and some of these inhabitants are imbued with the power of Hearthstone's newest mechanic, Reborn. Reborn minions return to life the first time they are destroyed, coming back with one health. This restless mummy also has Rush, meaning it comes back ready to rush right into another minion. The dead don't stay that way, not in Uldum. Well, I mean, they don't stay that way once. That guy's definitely dead now. If you're here visiting Uldum with slightly more nefarious intentions, Hagatha has created a shaman totem capable of calling in reinforcements, adding a lackey to your hand at the end of each of your turns. I bet you didn't know a totem could pick sides, but that one sure did. Uldum is full of plenty of more indifferent citizens as well, happy to work for anyone who makes a compelling enough offer. Jar Dealer is just such a fellow, a neutral minion with a death rattle, add a random one-cost minion to your hand. He's also the one to talk to if you ever need a jar. For all your jar needs. Buy, sell, trade, old jars, new jars, slightly used jars. Now, a land filled with the ruins of the mighty Titans wouldn't be complete without relics of unspeakable power. Behold, the puzzle box of Yogg-Saron. 10 random spells, 10 random targets, the cornerstone of any well-planned strategy. And so, the die is cast. Evil has set their dark plagues upon the world, and the brave League of Explorers are returning to stop them. Will our heroes triumph and save Azeroth? Or will the plagues that Rafam has unleashed destroy the world? And then everything just ends and there wouldn't be a third book. Yeah, we're all in really big suspense here.